Hello and welcome to DevLog 9. I'm Ian Lindsay from Game Digits, and this week I'll be going through the environment dressing, the object modelling process, and also the Unity presets. And while I'm making this puppet a sandwich, I'll just let you know that I've been modelling most of the week. No, not that kind of modelling. Instead, I've been modelling dressing objects in Blender and texturing them in Substance Painter. I think now would be a good time to show you how the three different types of environment objects are set up in the game. First, we have the static model. This is the main environment object that uses the texture arrays and the atlases. Then we have the static detail meshes, which are textured in Substance Painter and dynamically lit in the game. Lastly, we have the dynamic objects, and these are usually interactable by the player. Therefore, when creating environment objects, we first need to work out what type it is. So remember in the last devlog, I just had the static mesh with the texture atlases. So now it's time to model dressing objects at lightning speed. Okay, it's never really at lightning speed. 3D modelling takes time realistically, but there's a great sense of achievement when you finish an object. Photo frame done. As these objects can be picked up and handled by the player, I wanted them to be super detailed. Especially in VR, the more realistic an object is, the better really. So I focused on all the micro details within these objects. When modelling, I use PureRef to show some reference images, and using those as a guide, I model out the basic shape first. I then colour the vertices to create an ID map, so then I can apply different surfaces in Substance Painter to different parts of the mesh. Coffee machine done. For plants, you can use the solidify modifier with the fill option unticked to make them double-sided. Plant done. Plant pot done. Door done. Coffee button done. Tasty sandwich done.
Puppet looks done.
I was on a roll, but then I hit a problem. There were artifacts appearing on the textures when I imported them into Unity. After investigating, I found it was the compression format on the normal map. Those poor normals, they didn't stand a chance. Luckily, changing the format worked, so I used the Unity Preset Manager so it doesn't happen in the future. You can do this too by selecting the preset button in the inspector of an asset, and then save all the settings as a preset. So in this example, it'll save all the import settings of the texture, such as the texture compression and the size, and it'll save it in the preset file. Next, in the project settings, go to the preset manager and create a new texture importer. Then assign the preset file you saved earlier. Then you can add a naming convention for which assets to apply the import settings to. In my case, I use _normal for normal maps. Now this only applies the settings to newly imported assets, so if I delete the current normal map, then export it out again in Substance Painter. When it imports again, it'll take the import settings from the preset file. So this will fix the issue for any future normal maps that I want to import into the project. Also this week, I wanted to come up with a name and a logo for the hotel. So here's what I come up with in lightning speed. Felton. It's like the Hilton, but softer. Anyway, I thought I'd try out a new chair idea in the game, which has the task list and the help screen incorporated in it. But when I tried it in the game, it just didn't work. It was awkward to use. So I just took it out. So with the detail objects and the logo done, the office now looks like this. Thank you for watching Devlog 9, and for future devlogs, remember to like and subscribe to the channel. See you in Devlog 10.